What I'd say, everyone. Morning, Mike. Where is everyone else? Oh, here's George shouting out Guyana. 26 degrees. I suppose we don't get more Guyana shout outs. George giving the shout out to Georgetown. Always fun. Potentially, but I am scheduled to attend every single cup fixture going and all of the league fixtures up to the next big batch. So, we're not going to get more games skipped today because I'm not going to go beyond the big block of league fixtures. After that, we're done. And then I'll just do the same thing again. But yeah, we should be okay. But yeah, there might be more games happening on the same day, but we can't be skipping anymore. We should be okay. And with that, let's kick off. Whammer's our main event today. Whammer versus Calvin. So this is the first replay. These two teams, Tiki Takatoa came back from 2-0 down. Oh, Raheem Sterling flying up the wing. It'd be great to win the league without actually watching the games. I'm trying to think. We've not actually had that, to be fair. Most of our league winners are pretty good viewers. We've not had one of the non-viewers. Maybe Stefan, but that's a time zone issue. I don't know how many games Stefan managed to catch live in his title-winning season. So let's take another early lead. Gabigol scoring a goal. It's a crazy world. Mendy probably should do better than that. He has hands. Hands have fingers designed for holding. Yeah. To be fair, everyone... Well, I say everyone. Most people have won at least a few unstreamed seasons. I do a lot of test seasons. Yeah. Yeah, you've won multiple test seasons. There was one year where you were the best team, right? You won like 4 or 5 test seasons. That year, so. Oh, Timo Werner. Cuts his eye. Gabigol. They're going to go 2-0 up. Decent ball. Nothing doing though. There's going to be another bottom half team eliminating a top half team. What a story this would be. Give me a second. I will pull up my data. This setting. Okay, no, I was wrong. You aren't the best team. Although season 9 tests, you were the third best team, just behind the Manx in second and miles behind the Ducks. The Ducks were the best team by a fucking country mile that year. Not that it showed in the final standings, but you did win the league 4 times out of my 20 test seasons. Oh my god. Sirs are getting it done. No, that one's offside though. So yeah, season 9, you won more leagues than I did, but your average position was far more fluid. Less consistent. But yeah. 1 in 5 test seasons were the pigs. Who did win season 9? Hadley, probably. Was that Hadley year? Fourth best team. Yeah. Fourth best team in average position. There's still quite a lot of this season to play for, so people generally don't want that. As we get closer to the end, I'll share more of how the test seasons went for this year, but. Something to discuss as we go. Oh! We did it! Another bottom half team eliminates a top half team. What does that give us match wise? Let's make sure we're attending it. Manx versus Sirs. Here we go. Oh, another one there that I'm not attending. League. So, we're attending all of this nonsense. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Right. Valverde could leave the pocket dogs. That'd be exciting. We've never had a manager leave, have we? Just a manager go, you know what, I'm done. I want somewhere else. Well, I've only really tracked. My sheet only tracks season 9, 10, and 11. Before then, I just didn't really keep track of them. I just tested them and threw the results into the ether. Occasionally showed Mach funny ones. How did Wama do? So season 9 was the kids' year, so he came last every single season. Season 10, they were 9th overall. Didn't win a season, though. 3 teams below them did win. Including the 16th place on average Ducks did get a league win. A thrilling first half. Yeah, like if I'd been clever, I'd save each database individually. I think that's the thing I said I was going to try and do for FM22. I suppose I still can. I've not done any work for the next season. How long have we got? 2 weeks? So we've got 8 league games plus at least one stream for the cup. So we've got what, 9, 10 streams? What day is it today? What day of the week is it? Wednesday? It is Wednesday, go me. Ooh, there might not be a stream tomorrow. I should probably get that out there. Yeah, probably not going to be a stream tomorrow. I have to go find out whether my application to live in the country was successful or not. It's funny, they're like, so back in December when I went to my meeting, I hand over all the paperwork and they go, yeah, come back on, in this case, the 6th of January. There's no time, it's just come in on the 6th, speak to someone and see if they've got paperwork for you. It's just like, so we have to go there tomorrow and then find someone. I'm like, cool, here's me. Do you have paperwork saying I'm allowed to be here or not? Decent penalty for a medicine, you don't save those. Oh, Youssef En-Naziri. Maybe the kids have arrived, because that's definitely not a real person. You say it's cool. I'm not a huge fan. To be fair, I say that. If they give me my paperwork tomorrow and say I'm allowed to live here for the next X number of years, then I ain't gonna worry about it. I ain't gonna whinge. I'll take it. Plus, I got COVID tested this morning so I could go into the building tomorrow. Your boy's negative. Still weird, just pop down to the little... kind of like a mini walk-in set. I don't really know what it is. Like, it's like a little medical lab place that you just go and they run tests on you. Just turn up, give them a tenner, run a test, and then got the email. A couple hours later, yeah, you're negative. Good for you. Well, love to see it. Oh, dear. Defender gets away with a big error there. I guess it wouldn't have mattered anyway. A comfortable win for the Llamas. Yeah, like, the personal test things are good. But, like, I don't have to... it's not one of those ones that I can do at home, right? Like, the doctor shoves the stick up my nose and then runs whatever test she runs on it. Weird. It's always funny, though, when I go in, because the doctor says stuff to me in Romanian. I'm like, I have no idea what you're doing, love. Shove a stick up my nose and let me leave. But on the plus side, now that I've got that, there's like a 48-hour window where I'm allowed to like go and do things outside. So we're gonna see if I'm allowed to go to the cinema today, and if we are, and then assuming things go well tomorrow, more cinema trips. Love the cinema. Like just watching films. Oh, Jamal Rodri! Oh, Jamal and Rodri linking up there. Yeah, me too. That's one of the things I've missed the most about not being able to go out. Me and Raluca, especially when we're in the UK, because we could get Odeon Unlimited. Or whatever it was called, Odeon Plus or Odeon Limited, whatever it was. We used to literally go at least once a week and we just watch a film. And it was so good because the amount of films you watch that we're like, well, we'll watch it because it's free, essentially, to us to watch it, and we just want to watch something. And we've watched all of the ones we want to watch. And then you watch it, and you're like, okay, this might be one of the best films I've seen in months. Like, when we decided on a whim to go, what's this film about the Beatles or whatever? And we're just like, there's no way we're ever going to choose to watch Yesterday. And then we watched it, and we're like, this film's incredible. Oh! The pigs are turning on the style here. This is looking like the menace that played against Surreal. Oh yeah, Vert. Vert's involved in the build-up. The assist of the assist. Yesterday was so good. Like, and me and Luca, we both absolutely loved it. We're like, thank God for like Odium Unlimited, essentially, because we never would have watched it without it. It was so good. It did very well on my end of year rankings that year. Film that didn't do so well was fucking, what's it called? Oh, Maleficent 2. That film did not do well. I'm pretty sure that was the same year. Let me tell you, not a fan of that one. That was shite. Why would you ever need to pause? See, that's why I don't like streaming services, is because people think it's okay to pause the film I'm trying to watch. The only plus side is when I'm in a cinema with other people. I fucking hate that because other people don't understand how to be in cinemas. Whatever you're doing, do it. Just, I need you to sit perfectly still. Don't eat anything. Don't drink anything. Just sit in silence. That's all I need from you. Okay. You can go to the toilet when the film's finished. As I said, no eating or drinking while the film is on. Did Wurtz get the assist? He did! Florian Wurtz with the assist. Yeah, exactly, George. Exactly. You can pee before you go in, and one of the wonderful things about being a grown-up, you can hold it. You can hold it till the end of the film. But if you're someone that likes to eat, drink, and go to the toilet during the film, I am glad you have access to streaming services and you understand that they are better for you than the cinema. This was lovely. Tammy Abraham loves a late goal. Sadly, this one not a winner. You remember when we all thought the Menace were gonna do it? Three-time league winners. Bit less confident in that now. Pigs. Back in with a shout, you know. Pigs could do it. Are the Weasels ever going to play a league game again? That's the question on everyone else's lips. Glad I trusted Ten Hag all season. Paying off. Funny chap. Oh, it's the Ducks in our away kit. Oh, I forgot. Yeah, we've got the drumstick lolly. That's another thing. Popcorn. That shit shouldn't exist in cinemas. Whilst I understand that it's convenient for them because they make shitloads of money. It makes so much fucking mess. And why have they got one of the noisiest snacks available? Oh, Big Mario has missed. He's put it wide. That's awkward. Oh, Victor. Oh. Oh yeah, Big Mario. Big Mario is a different player. Oh dear. All over the shop today. Victor Osimhen's decided today's the day he's going to be good. Wait, didn't he score 2 goals against me in the first time we played? Is he literally only scoring against the Ducks? Every other team, he puts it wide. Ducks? Well-oiled fucking goal-scoring machine. Go on, Messi. What was that, JJ? Oh. Man, we're shit. It's fine, we're going to win the cup. Don't give a shit about the league. We'd just like more draws, I guess. For historical draw awards. Oh my god, Aubameyang. Oh, Aubameyang, yes! So, weird thing. Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain, obviously his name was too long, so it used to get abbreviated to Alex... dot dot dot, right? Aubameyang's name, too long. They just cut it off. That was just Pierre-Emerick Aubameyang. Weird, innit? Hey, good for the historical draw records. I said I wanted more draws. I'll take it. Surreal. A preview of the cup matchup. Surreal won the first time round. Can Surreal do the league double ahead of their cup matchup? Can Manchester level the playing field and give us the tiebreaker in the cup? Oh, he care. Pretty sure this goal's been disallowed. Oh, it stands! Great start here for Manchester. Not the start Surreal were hoping for. What the fuck is this guy doing? You're playing as the fullback. How have you ended up there? Fucking hell. Borna Barisic. Not great. Oh, Ronnie. Oh, okay. Barisic didn't know what he was doing for the first goal, but that was good interception there. Oh. Semedo just runs straight at some big lad. Oh, good ball from Hector. DCL denied by one of the few players in the league that's bigger than him. Surreal have actually managed to fill the stands far more than they usually do. Attendances must be on the up and up after their winning the cup. They got the fans believing. I think that's reasonable. I just like the giant screen. It just makes things look bigger. It's also just like the novelty of a day out. I like being able to just go out and do something. Luke and I almost always will grab dinner out as well. Like, especially when we're in the UK. Like, once a week we'd go out, have dinner, and watch film. It was nice. Just even if, like, 50-60% of the time we wouldn't go anywhere particularly fancy, we'd just go to Nando's. But sometimes we go for a nice dinner. Oh my God, Surreal level. Surreal level. Are they gonna do it again? Yeah. No, the Odeon we had was IMAX, so we'd watch all the IMAX films in IMAX. Riley's not a huge IMAX fan because it's too loud. Like, it does run a bit. Especially if you're watching like an action film, which is mostly just over the top explosions. It can get a bit much. I for one enjoy it because it drowns out the fucking annoying people. I hate. Oh! The manager's brought himself on! The manager is on the pitch! Maybe his first appearance of the season. Marcus is like, alright, dickheads. I'm in charge. Yeah, this is a league match. It looks like we're not going to get any additional cup. We only got the one cup replay today as our only cup game. Oh, DCL goes by the keeper for a late winner. Oh, dear. Maychester equalise the league scores the cup one for all the marbles to win the BO3. Congrats to Maychester. Here we have two of our bottom half teams who have eliminated upper half teams in the cup already. Okay, nice. All Sterling. Oh, I forget, another one of the best things about going to the cinema is they sell Ben and Jerry's ice cream. And you can get those little like Ben and Jerry's like sundaes. The whipped cream and the nuts and the two flavours. Oh. Although I'm a big believer if you shouldn't actually mix flavours, you should just pick one flavour and get it. Oh! Ziyech, it's deflected in. How are we only 8 minutes in? I feel like we may have watched the full match at this point. Sirs, looking good. Look like they may well enjoy post-split life. Then again, Fitness Fabio has greatly improved things at half man. Being better than Conte, not really the achievement it used to be. Oh, Gabigol. Gabigol loads it down to Ziyech. Nothing doing. Oh, Gabigol. Yeah, no, you should never buy food at the cinema. outside of an ice cream. You shouldn't buy food. It is. It's not good. And everyone knows it's not good, but they still get tricked into it. That's why me and Luca like going out for dinner beforehand, because that way you didn't need to worry about it. Go to Nando's, buy half a chicken and a couple sides, split it. Well, ice cream isn't really food, is it? I wouldn't consider ice cream food in most circumstances. Also, if you make noise eating an ice cream, you're eating your ice cream wrong. Popcorn, very noisy. Nachos, noisy. Those fucking crinkly plastic shit that they serve everything in, noisy. Have an ice cream, eat it before the film starts. Problem solved. Half the times you eat it before you've even got into the fucking screen. Oh! Felipe Anderson. What are you doing? Can you though? Everyone says it. Felipe, your feelings. Oh dear. Oh! Take me to cheese. So, Nikki, just a quick heads up. This joke works because Chiesa in Italian means church, and we're aware of that. So it's a fun play on the fact it looks like the word cheese, but we could use, obviously, the famous phrase, take me to church, like the Hosier song. Switch it up a little bit. Got ourselves a joke. Seconds, not very many seconds to score a goal. Pellegrini, oh. Aguero scored, what, 2 goals this year? Yeah. His XG is actually only 1.4. It's crazy how his XG is so low. I got you back, Nicky. Here to help. Hi, Vince. Jeep me to church. Oh, Rilva goes down. But no penalty given. Referee thinks he's a dirty... lying bastard. Cobbling your stockings for that. No, it's Tilva versus Rilva today. It wasn't the last stream the Bilva versus Dilva matchup. Here we are with Tilva versus Rilva. Who won the last one? Is it going to be some like... elimination top four bracket situation? Is this the other semi-final? I'm assuming Bilva won, because Losios have been doing lots of losing, and I'm pretty sure Halfman beat them. Oh! That didn't go in? That looked like it went in. You've missed. The Llamas won. The Llamas won a game, and you missed it. Tiki Taka Toa were eliminated from the cup by a bottom half side. Pigs are good again. Ducks picked up a draw. What else has happened? Maychester scored an injury time winner to beat Surreal. Who did you beat? The Manx? I want to say the Manx. Like 3-0? 2-0? Something like that. El Naziri scored. I remember that much. He scored the second. Oh, João Felix gets blocked by the defender. Oh, Harry the Candy Cane. Oh, Sandro on a yellow. Brave as all balls to go flying in there. 2-0. El Naziri scored the second. Don't tell me. I'm going to remember who scored the first goal. It happened in the last 30 minutes. How hard can this be, Reese? Come on. The only other Llamas player I can think of at the minute is Grealish, but I don't think he scored. But I will submit him as my answer. He might have. Almost certain it wasn't, but he might have. Damn. I wasn't confident in the answer, but we gave it anyway. And we got ourselves to blame. Yes, but he was drafted as Rafa Silva. That's why he gets entered as Rilva. Madison. The other English attacking midfielder. But we like Madison because he loves Norwich. Fuck Grealish though. Matip? Hello? What? What was that? Yes, Tilva does get known as Tilva. Hence that game being Rilva versus Tilva, the second semi-final. Has anyone worked out what Matip was doing for the first... Oh, Gareth Bale! Gareth Bale scored a goal! They're the four that we recognise. There are definitely other Silvers in the league. Like, when I search the editor by Silver, I get far more than just them four. I think Neymar's got Silver in his name. There's definitely one of the common things I search that Neymar turns up in. Might be silver. But no one has ever called Neymar Silver, so he doesn't get to be Nilva. Love that Gareth Bale's picked up a goal. Oh, Dybala. That's a point. How many different... how many players have scored in all 11 seasons? Can't be too, obviously, Gareth Bale's not one of them because he was golfing for 2 years. But that'd be quite an interesting thing to look at. Who do we know? All right, Ronnie, obviously Ronnie Messi. You reckon there's more than 20, maybe 40 players? Yeah, yeah, there'll be quite a lot, won't there? I think all the strikers. Chiro. Zlatan? I don't think Zlatan's ever laid an egg. No, you'd be surprised. There are very few centre-backs that have. Most of the centre-backs have missed one. Yeah, like season one is where you start. Because obviously it was the smallest season. And the least well drafted. We had no fucking idea what we were doing. Lots of just clicking buttons. How many different people have ever scored? That's another good stat. Way more than 200. Way more than 200. Surely. It's got to be way more than 200, right? Right, these are all good questions that are inspiring me to maybe spend some time, go back and update my master player stat sheet. So I can have a fiddle about and answer some of these questions. Oh, Goretzka pulls one back. Like the ambition of getting the ball out the back of the net. It's the fifth minute of four additional minutes and you've just made it 3-1. Yeah, we weren't particularly good season one. Like, particularly good most seasons, to be fair. I probably need to add the season one caveat to that. Yeah, I think Ramos gets by because he's a penalty taker on a lot of them. Mueller, he'll be an 11 out of 11, I reckon. I don't think he's ever failed. How's it offside? There's a player stood on the line. Virgil. Big Virg. 11 out of 11. Fair play. Oh no! Luis Muriel with an absolute tap-in. Oh dear, the keeper's been bamboozled by his own defender there. Suarez, there you go, he's on the slam dunk 11 out of 11, Luis Suarez. Mueller, this one, not offside, this one counts. So yeah, I reckon my guess would be 27. 27 11 of 11s. I wonder if there's any that are on 10 of 10 but currently yet to score. In this one. Is Luis Alberto an 11 of 11? I don't think he is. I feel like 1 year he didn't score. Season 5, he didn't score. Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Tony M not being good on FM 20 isn't too much of a shock. Oh, is Muriel? Puts it wide. Like, it's entirely possible Haaland failed one of the first couple seasons. Oh, Mancini. Yeah, exactly. It's definitely super easy to miss out on that. And you gotta think, there was also lots of football being taken up by players like Big Gonzo, who's since no longer in the league, right? And he'll have taken up a lot of game time in the first few seasons. Here comes Lucky. Everyone's favourite South African centre back. Haaland is 11 of 11. Fair enough. I'd have guessed he was, but I was just saying it's definitely possible he would have missed one of the early seasons. What's his worst season? Goal worst. Scored one goal season 3. There you go. See? It's entirely possible that he would have missed, but. Grab one. There's enormous normness getting the start. Things we love to see. Chiro. Can't find them titty. Two kids in the starting 11. For the arguably league favourites at this point. Luis Alberto is 11 of 11. Love that. Love that. Oh! It's enormous normness with the cheekiest of dinks. Big Norm with a big goal. Has four ones. Yeah, he does. Luis Alberto gets his stat confirmed as his long time. We were lining Norman Onyango up to be the future Luis Alberto, but 1, 2, 3, and 7. Oh. Man, I love Luis Alberto, and I don't really know why. It's so crazy that I drafted him in Season 1, because if I don't just draft him on a whim in Season 1, none of this Luis Alberto love affair ever happens. Which is crazy to think about. Morata in the bin. Virgil van Dijk in. Luis Alberto in. Alvaro Morata out. I don't know if he has scored this season. Benzema in, I guess. Benzema's always good for 5 or 6. Oh, Morata didn't even get drafted season one. Put him in the bin. Pjanic. Oh, Pjanic is one of our 10 of 10s at risk. The elves are good. The elves are definitely good. Yeah, I think Griezmann would have been on the obvious list. Timo Werner. Check that. There's someone who's maybe on the list, but could definitely have whiffed a couple seasons. After all, he was a backup left midfielder for the Ducks multiple seasons. Yeah, I'm pretty sure I drafted him season one. Or it might have been season two I started drafting him. Yeah, but I think so. No goal season one. Yeah, as expected. Or 5. I'm going to assume that one wasn't my fault. Here's an interesting one that could have failed. Firmino. I feel like he always gets a couple. Oh, was Timo in the striker season? Yeah. He's a good choice because he could play. Yeah, he was playing in midfield though for the striker team. He was playing right or left midfield. And probably quite a few of them off the bench, I guess. Oh, Neymar on the back post! Dogs back as title favourites. Big game coming up. Dogs versus Pythons. Our main event. If the Pythons win, do they go top of the table? Is Whammer going to win the league? Or, oh, even worse, is Whammer... Is Whammer going to finish in the top 3 for the first time ever? Oh, I fucking hate you all. Oh, Benzema! Go on! Kareem! No, I forgot to shoot. Whew. If Firmino scored in season 8, he's 11 of 11. He definitely could have not scored in season 8. Who did he play for season 8? Oh, did Firmino sit out a year? That's definitely possible. Firmino definitely could have sat out a year with Core. Ah, yeah, that was the year they sat out, right? Oh, so he would be perfect if Core hadn't taken a sabbatical. Oh, Jeffrey! Someone stop this kid. Oh. Well, I had him the season before. Interesting. Ah, was season 9 the season he sat out then? Well, so he obviously just didn't play or score then. He obviously would have played, but he obviously just didn't score. I think season 8 was when I stopped updating my sheet, so Mach won't have Mate won't have appearance numbers. And obviously, no goal means no goal. I don't think he will have. I can check. Jeffrey Weir is going to send the Pythons top of the league. Oh dear. On the plus side, George has a game in hand. George has a game in hand. It's fine. The Weasels are still going to win the league. But I would still like the Pythons to finish fourth. Oh, Soler! Levels it up. The Pythons are back in it. We love this, love this. Yeah, love a draw. Draws are good. I should start handing out points deductions. I don't think I can do them in game. But oh, Sadio Mane's gifted one! Sadio Mane, the king of the gifts. Should I just send all the teams into administration until the Ducks win? What is Mike doing? Eh? What is this? Mike's having an absolute nightmare. Jeffrey. Oh, great ball. Tony Cruz. Yep. Rashford. Is Rashford 11 of 11? Probably, right? I kid, I don't need to do it. I've already won the league once. I've got my one league win, I'm happy. That'll see me off. Until everyone else has one. Pythons, oh, stay in third. Nice, nice. Pocket Dogs, back in the driving seat. Pigs up to fourth. Well, what a world. Right, save that. Oh, someone been sacked? Oh, oh. Well, that's sad. That is sad. Oh. Sorry, Mircha. Well, I guess I'll have to have a think about what I'm doing now. When's the cup replay? At some point. Tomorrow, most likely. Oh, no, there's probably not a stream tomorrow. There's probably not a stream tomorrow, so I guess Friday. I might do an evening stream. If people remind me that I've said I might do an evening stream. Not today, but tomorrow, to make up for the lack of day stream. But anyway, this was fun, even if it was the end of my manager. Much love, be good, and see you on the flip side, by which point hopefully I'll be a legal resident of this country. Toodaloo.